Hello and season's greetings. I'm Ken Drews, and here's an updated winter weather outlook for southeast Arizona. Today is December 20th, 2012. Winter officially begins at 4:12 a.m. Friday, December 21st. Since these long-range forecasts can vary a lot from issuance to issuance, it's probably best not to use this briefing after the first week of January. As you know, winter storms have been tracking close enough to southeast Arizona over the past week or so to bring us some much-needed precipitation. That pattern is expected to continue through the holidays, but as you can see from this 8 to 14 day precipitation outlook, the wettest weather will likely be just north of us. But at the very least, we should be able to add to our precipitation totals this winter over the next couple of weeks, so that is good news for many of us. The recently updated temperature outlook for January through March from the Climate Prediction Center continues to show a warmer winter than average across southeast Arizona. Average highs and lows for selected cities in southeast Arizona are shown here, with highs typically in the 60s and lows generally in the 30s and 40s. While the precipitation outlook for December through February had neither a wet or dry bias, the precipitation outlook for January through March, shown here, continues to indicate drier than average conditions. The previous outlook for these same 3 months actually showed a higher probability of being dry across southeast Arizona. While in some sense this is good news, we're also not seeing any signals indicating that we could end up with an overly wet end to winter or start to spring either. Average January through March precipitation totals for selected cities in southeast Arizona are shown here, with most valley locations normally picking up somewhere around 2 inches, with Clifton and Oracle averaging over 3 inches and 7 inches respectively due to their proximity to mountains. Since the long-range forecast calls for below-average precipitation, prospects for improving our drought status are bleak, but then again we are not seeing indications of drought intensification either. Despite the recent precipitation, most of southeast Arizona remains in a moderate drought, with a few spots still experiencing severe drought conditions. Thanks for listening. I hope you found this briefing informative. Remember, you can get the latest information from the National Weather Service in a variety of ways, including Facebook and Twitter. If you are traveling for the holidays, remember that you can access weather from around the country at weather.gov. Happy holidays and stay safe.